Hello guys, welcome once again in the study trip. Hope that you all must be enjoying and studying at home. Guys, before starting the video, come let's press the bell icon and subscribe the channel. Guys, if you have book, you can open on exercise 5. Exercise 5 has been given the nouns and kinds of nouns. We are going to study about the kinds of noun today and the right uses of kinds of noun. Okay. Now guys, as we all know the definition of noun. What is a noun? A noun is a naming word in a simple language. I'll try my best to take you all in a very very simple way guys. So every line you can get it to your mind. A noun. A noun is the name of a thing, place, person, a quality or an idea. We all know that. Now today we are going to study about the different types of nouns. Few examples has been given here. Proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun, abstract noun. Abstract noun has two kinds. Okay, attributive nouns and verbal nouns. We are going to have a discussion about these types of noun. Okay guys, before starting the video, I will request you guys to please watch the full videos. Do not skip the video and watch. After watching the video, go to the comment box, write your name in the comment box so we can take your attendance. Every day attendance will be taken in all the subjects. It is mandatory to go to the comment box and mention your name. So it will be easy to make your attendance. Okay guys, and every second Saturday we are going to conduct a small test. It is compulsory, it is very mandatory, it is mandatory to attend the test guys. Well, come, let's get started. In the previous class we have studied about the noun, kinds of noun. So we are going to learn once again about the kinds of noun, but in this class we will study about the right uses of these nouns. Okay guys, if possible, please note it down all everything in the fair copy in a good writing and mention the date right up here in your copy. Okay, different types. We were talking about different types of noun. There are proper noun, common noun. We are going to discuss about these only today. Proper noun, common noun, collective noun, material noun, abstract noun. Abstract noun has two types, attributive nouns and verbal noun. First is proper noun. Okay? Well guys, come, let's go through the kinds of noun. First is proper noun. Names of particular persons. See, I have mentioned here guys, particular person. Okay, particular person. Suppose that Mr. George, Mr. Hawkins, okay, or place as for Delhi, Calcutta, Mumbai, okay, Bangalore, such as George. I have mentioned it here in the example. Names of particular person or place such as George, Meena, Delhi, Nepal. These are the examples of proper noun. And proper noun is always used, always started with the capital letters. Always remember that guys, in the beginning of the video, in the exercise when we had started our lesson 1, I had made you understand. Do not write in this way. Okay, purposely I have mentioned it all in the capital letters so that it will be, so that you can read it very carefully, very clearly. Okay guys, next is, here I have mentioned a proper noun always begins with a capital letter. Okay, next, first is proper noun, second is common noun here. General names for people, general names for people, general names for people, animals, okay, things or objects that can belong to a common class. Common class, if I talk that he is a boy, he is a boy, so it is not clarified which boy I am talking about. He went to that place. The place name is not clarified here. If I would say that he went to Delhi, So it is clarified that yes, he went to Delhi. He went that place. It is not cleared here. Okay, he is a boy. If I say yes, he is Ram or he is Shohan. She is Gita. So it is clarified that yes, the certain girl is, we are talking about, is Gita or Sita. He is a boy, she is a boy, which boy or girl I am talking about, it is not clarified here. Okay, so common nouns, general names for people, animal, things or object that belong to a common class, that belong to a common class, such as man, woman, boy, horse, etc. Is it clear? Go to the third one. Third one is material noun. Third, material noun is very very easy, guys. The thing is that you have to concentrate and sit down and watch the video. Okay, words that refer to substances or material. Okay, refers to substances or materials such as milk, sugar, salt, okay, oil. So these are the examples of material noun, right guys? Gold, silver. Next, come to the collective nouns. I will bring few more examples of collective nouns in my next video, guys, because collective nouns, we use the collective nouns in many ways. Okay guys, collective nouns, names of thing, object and person that are referred to as a group. Okay, such as people, team, nation, herd, a bunch of keys, a bunch of banana, a bunch of bananas, a bunch of grapes, okay, a pride of lion, a galaxy of stars. These all are examples of collective nouns, right guys? Shall we come to the next one? Abstract noun. Next is the fifth one, abstract noun. Words that refer to qualities, that refers to qualities, conditions, idea or action. Okay, feelings and emotions such as beauty, anger, happiness. Okay, poverty, knowledge, work, wisdom, anger, etc. These are the examples of abstract noun. Well guys, next is abstract noun. In the beginning I have made you understand that abstract noun has two types. Okay, first is attributive. Names of qualities, characteristics or attributes are called attributive nouns. This is very easy guys, okay. I will bring a second video of this event to make you more understand. Names of qualities, characteristics or attributes are called attributive nouns. Such nouns can be formed from, you, the point is here guys, this one. Okay, you have to be careful. Such nouns can be formed from adjective and nouns, from the noun types. Okay guys, for example, poverty. Poverty is brought from the adjective poor. Well, okay. Next, scholarship. Scholarship from the common. Scholarship is coming from the common noun. Okay. Now, scholar. Scholar is my common noun here. Okay. So, scholarship from the common nouns. Okay. Scholar. Right guys, these are examples of attributive nouns. Shall we come to the next one? Next guys, verbal noun. Okay, nouns that are formed by adding ing or er. Okay, once again, nouns that are formed by adding an inflection such as, that is called inflection. Okay, such as ing or er, these are called inflection. Okay, to verb sharing the constructions are known as verbal nouns. For example, such example I have given here, examiner. Examiner from examine. See here, examine. ER is added over here. Okay, next is designer from design. Okay, designer from design. Walking, ing is here. Walking from walk. These are ing, ER, ER. These are all inflections. Okay guys, now another note is here. Another classification of noun is whether they are countable or uncountable. Okay? Well guys, now countable noun and uncountable noun, which we were talking about. Countable noun. Countable nouns are the names of objects, people, etc. Okay, which we can count. Okay, that we can count. For example, book, toy, fan, whiteboard, marker. Okay, now next is uncountable noun. Even this is very easy, guys. Uncountable nouns that are the names of the things that we cannot count it. Okay, we cannot count. Example, milk. Can you count the milk? No, not at all. Coffee? No, not at all. Sugar? Not at all. Okay, so uncountable nouns are the names of things that we cannot count. For example, milk, tea, oil, gold, beauty, honesty. Okay, these all words we cannot count. Okay, but you have to be very, very careful here, guys. Note, I have written it here, mentioned it here. They merely denote substances and abstract things. This you have to be very, very careful. Okay, guys, hope that you all enjoyed a lot today in my video and learned many more things, guys. Okay, but least and not last, guys, I would like to request you once again to don't forget to make your attendance by going to the comment box. Okay, go to the comment box and just mention the name in all the subjects, guys. It is mandatory to make your attendance every day. Okay, thank you very much, guys. Thank you for watching the video. Thank you very much. Have a good day.